Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life of a Network Engineer. So this channel will be mostly on networking and also some of the learnings what I have learned in my life. It will be more of an informative channel. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. So we'll skip to the video now. So this video will be more on zero touch provisioning in Cisco SD-WAN. So this video will give you an entire overview of how a zero touch provisioning is done in Cisco SD-WAN. Okay, so I'll just tell you what are the components of Cisco SD-WAN. There are four components basically: vManage, vSmart, vBot and vEdge. I'll just brief on what are they. So vManage is the centralized dashboard which controls the entire SD-WAN environment. Okay, it's more like a login GUI where you see the entire environment. Okay, vSmart is the brain of the SD-WAN. So this vSmart decides which routing to happen, which policies to be implemented in which location, or in other words, in high level, I can just say that which location can talk to which location and what are the traffic flows, everything. So that will be decided by the vSmart. And vBot is more like a security front that decides which vEdge should come in and which should not come in. And it is more like a VRF environment. So this acts as a security check before any vEdge comes into the environment. And vEdge is nothing but CPE equipment, what we have been traditionally using. vEdge is a next level of CPE. It can have the lot of configurations which are required for the traffic flow. So we'll see how the zero touch provisioning workflow works. Okay, I have given a put up an entire diagram for this, so I'll just tell you step by step so that will be easy for you to identify. I'll just brief on what are the components here. The first one is the existing vEdge or cEdge. So Viptela, as you know, was a separate SD-WAN entity and later it was bought by Cisco. This vEdge terminology is from Viptela, so it has been converted to cEdge as well, which is Cisco Edge. But still I don't feel that most of the terminologies have changed. So still they are running with their own ZTP server, vEdge, vBot and vSmart. Okay, and here we can see that this is an existing vEdge or cEdge, so we are bringing in a new vEdge. Okay, and as we have discussed before, this is a vBot, this is a vManage and this is a vSmart. Okay, and ZTP server is nothing but a zero touch provisioning server. It comes under a URL of ztp.viptela.com. This will be used for zero touch provisioning in this architecture. Okay, so I'll tell you how the traffic flow works. So once this new vEdge is bought from the Cisco, the Cisco will have their own database, okay, of the vEdges which are sold to a separate organization. So once this device is shipped to the customer's environment, the serial number of that vEdge will be installed in their environment along with the vBot IP, so that this zero touch provisioning server will have the database of the all the serial numbers or all the vEdge serial numbers which have been shipped from Cisco and the corresponding vBot IPs of that vEdge. Okay, so once this vEdge is powered on, it will have a serial number and a certificate. So once it is powered on, it will try reaching the router. So it's just a broadband router, that is more than enough. So by default, once that is turned on, it sends a DHCP request, and that DHCP request will reach the router and you'll get a DHCP and DNS entry from there. So now this new vEdge will have its own public IP, right, to reach to the external. So and the DNS entry is also there. So it by default reaches to the internet for the ZTP server, which is ztp.viptela.com. So it sends its query to the ZTP server. Okay, and as I said before, this ZTP server will have the IP address of the vBot, which is corresponding to this vEdge serial number. So it will give its vBot IP to the new vEdge. So now this new vEdge has the IP address of the vBot, correct? So the next authentication step will be to send an authentication and initial communication to the vBot. So what is meant by authentication? So authentication is nothing but the initial check. So this vEdge will tell its initial communication details, like this is my serial number, this is my certificate, and this is my system IP and all those stuffs. So once that is received by the vBot for a particular organization, as I said, is a security check. So it will have the entire database of the vEdges which are in the environment. So as a user, they'll have to upload the vEdge serial number in the vBot. That can be done in two ways: in a manual end, if there is only one device which is coming on or a very few number of devices coming in, they can do it through a manual entry, or if a bulk VHS are coming to be implemented in that environment, then the VBOT will have its own CSR file. This CSV file will be having the data, the serial numbers of all the VHS, and that CSV file will be uploaded into the VBOT. So this VBOT will have the entire database of all the serial numbers. It will validate its database and see that, okay, if this VHS is part of our environment, it is supposed to be part of our environment. So then it will validate, because this serial number will be already there and the certificate will be there. So it validates the certificate and the serial number. And then after the initial security check authentication, it will be sending the IP address of vManage and vSmart. Okay, so now this new VH will have the IP address of VBOT, VManage and vSmart. And there is one more thing what VBOT does, because it has received an authentication from the new VH, it will immediately communicate that message to the VManage that one of our new router has come into picture and you will be getting a authentication message from him shortly. The VManage will be ready for that new VH's communication. So immediately once it receives the VManage and the vSmart IP, this new VH then sends the authentication message to VManage. So this VManage will then receive that authentication, do the initial checks, and as it has already got a message from VBOT, it will compare that as well. And then the authentication is successful, it will send the configuration file, the entire configuration file to the VH. So this new VH will download the configuration and then run its configuration in a database, and then it will be saving and rebooting, and it will come up with the new IP address and with the entire configuration what it is supposed to have. So as I said before, VBOT has already given him the VManage and the vSmart IPs. So now this new VH will be connecting to the vSmart as well. So this will be again an authentication packet. As I said, vSmart is the brain of the entire architecture. So it will again authenticate and validate this new VH. And once that authentication is done, they'll be exchanging the route. So what it will do? So this VH will be sending its own entire routing database to this vSmart. Then the vSmart will vice versa send its entire routing database to this VH. So this VH will be now totally up with all the routing table and all the policies, everything required. And it will be ready to be functional. So the final step in this is to form an IPsec tunnel between the existing VH and the new VH. So it now it will have the database of this VH as well. So it will create an IPsec tunnel between these two and form an BFD establishment. BFD is nothing but a bidirectional forwarding, just to eliminate if there is a flap or something to identify that, right? So this IPsec tunnel will be happening. So this IPsec tunnel will be used for traffic flow from this VH to this VH, and all the underlay traffic will be happening from VH to VH only. Only the overlay traffic will be happening between the VH and the VBOT, VManage and vSmart. Okay, so this is how the entire zero touch provisioning works. Hope this video was useful to you guys. So please subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed. If you feel this video is informative, you can please share this channel to your friends. Thanks for your time guys. Happy learning.